This is a production of PBS Charlotte.
John Leek and his son Jay are artisans in the classic sense of the word.
We make one piece at a time for one customer at a time.
They are third and fourth generation master craftsmen, skilled in the reproduction of 18th century furniture. Be it Queen Anne, Chippendale, Hepplewhite, or Sheraton, their customers know the Leeks can recreate their favorite antique style. And they do it the old-fashioned way, which is mostly by hand. But this summer, the Leeks were asked to make something a bit more contemporary.
So we were contacted about the White House needing a special box that they needed on the President and First Lady's official visit over to England to see the Queen.
The White House request came just 10 days before the big trip. And because the Leeks were working on other orders at the time, the request put their two-man operation under tremendous pressure.
First question was, can you do this? And we thought, of course. We're not going to say no. We didn't know how we was going to do it, but we knew we had to do it.
But this would not be an easy job. The White House wanted the box emblazoned with an image of the official residence, made to specific dimensions, and constructed with wood sourced from a tree off the White House lawn.
We think, in working with it, that the particular wood was basswood.
There's likely some symbolism in the type of wood the White House chose to send to the Leeks for the Queen's box. This is basswood, a type of tree native to England, but when brought over to America, seemed to thrive. The Queen's gift box was completed and overnighted to Washington with just enough time to be loaded onto Air Force One. But the Leek family legacy did not start or end with this project.
We're in our 63rd year up here.
The Leeks workshop stands on the original family farm on Route 321 in York, South Carolina. They started in the furniture business in the mid-1950s with John's grandparents, Howard and Zoe Leek, who traded in antiques.
And my dad joined them in the business about 1966.
And it was John's dad, Buddy, who added furniture repair and restoration to the family business. Then John, who upon taking over the business in the 1980s, decided to pivot entirely into furniture making.
Our business has changed a little bit. We're no longer dealing in antiques, but we're the same family in the same location, still messing with furniture. It's just we're making the antiques instead of selling them.
In fact, it was the Leeks' reproduction of an 18th century cellarette, which is a locked and portable liquor cabinet, that likely brought their handiwork to the attention of White House staff. The mahogany piece with its intricate walnut inlay was featured in a 2014 National Magazine competition. Although the father and son duo didn't win, they won over plenty of new customers, many of whom live along the Mid-Atlantic region.
We have quite a bit of furniture in the Washington, D.C. area over the years, Maryland, Virginia, D.C., and you know, about everybody up there is tied into the government somehow or another.
The Leeks believe word of mouth is what helped them secure another government project, this time making dresser boxes for the U.S. State Department.
We just got an email one day about these boxes, and they sent us a picture of one that is in a collection in Washington, but it would be a federal box made post-revolution. That's why it has this eagle in here.
Although the Leeks revised the design of the federal box from the 18th century original, they think their recreation can stand the test of time.
Hopefully our box will be just as handsome and beautiful and patinaed as this in 200 years.
The boxes are presented as gifts by the State Department to visiting dignitaries. But no matter where in the world these boxes end up, they'll always bear their maker's mark.
It says, proudly made by hand in York, South Carolina, USA, by John and Jay Leek.
Left, bottom, right.
In watching these men work, you soon realize what's really being built here fits tighter than the joints that hold together this wooden box. It's the relationship between father and son.
Special. You know, like he said, we're lucky.
And their luck continues as business is booming and there is a wait list for their handmade pieces. For Carolina Impact, I'm Joanne Davis reporting.